that case, what's the problem with me trying to impress you? Oh my god. I would die for this main character. Beautifuls, this is Aromi here. Welcome back to Doki Doki Literature Club. We are here finally helping Natsuki because she finally wants to be a grown girl and ask us for help. Well, kind of. I hold the chair while Natsuki reaches back up. Are you okay? I can almost no! I can almost see up her skirt! No! Don't look! I forced myself to turn away. Natsuki seriously didn't think this through. When she realizes, I'll be dead. Natsuki wraps her arm around the Parfait Girls box set, easily the largest one on the shelf.
Ooh, heavy.
Hey, Michiko. I don't think I can bend down without falling. Hurry and take this one. Huh? But then I have to let go of the chair. That's fine. Just for a second. Hurry up. All right. Let me just stand up. I slowly release my grip from the chair. What do you mean, stand up? Natsuki looks down at me. Why are you all the way back? Natsuki looks like she realized something, but she'll lose her balance if she moves. Natsuki, the box! Well, what are you looking at? You're trying to look up. No, like. You're trying to look at my. Natsuki. Natsuki's legs shake. I'm not! I was just. Natsuki, don't try to move! Just give me the box! You perv! You set me up! I didn't do anything, Natsuki! I told you to use a tall person! Go away! Get out! But I'll do it myself! The chair suddenly swivels beneath Natsuki's feet. Natsuki! There she goes, tumbling. The scene turns to chaos in a split second. The chair flies from under Natsuki's feet. Frantically, I try to catch her. The box topples out of her hand, and the books go flying. I got you! We got her straight in the butt. You saw that zoom in? It went straight to her butt. The full force of Natsuki's body against me throws me to the ground. A whole bunch of books pelt me in the face. Oh my god, his poor face. Aw, I hope you didn't get any paper cuts or boo-boos after that. Natsuki tries to shield herself with her own arms as her face lands straight on my chest.
Ugh.
My right arm and back seriously felt the impact. This would have all been avoided if you just used a tall person, Natsuki. Slowly, Natsuki comes to her senses. She presses her arm straight into me to prop herself up.
Huh?
Natsuki seems to realize that it's not the floor that's beneath her.
Mm, gross! Gross!
I didn't do anything. A fist pounds into my chest. Natsuki then hoists herself to her feet. What were you thinking? You sicko? Everything okay over there? I heard a loud noise. Monika suddenly peers in.
Monika! See what happens when you put the manga on the top shelf? Are you trying to kill your club members or something? Jeez!
Sorry! Oh, and one more thing. It seems like your most recent club member is a total pervert. So I hope you're happy. I didn't! Somehow it's impossible for me to explain this whole bizarre situation to Monika. I didn't do anything, I swear.
I know, don't worry.
Monika says that quietly to me. Looks like I'm off the hook.
Oh no! My...
Uh-oh, are her books okay? I look down. Natsuki is kneeling on the floor holding one of the books that are scattered all over. There's a large diagonal crease along the page that she's desperately trying to smooth out. It must have landed on the page. Natsuki tries a bit more to fix the crease, but she can't get it out. Suddenly, she gives up and slams the book shut, then throws it to the floor. Instead of continuing to yell, she just lowers her head. Oh no, is she crying? Natsuki, are you...
No!
Oh no, don't cry, my love! Natsuki's voice squeaks.
Natsuki,
I see tears on her face.
I'll help get the crease out, okay?
It's partially my fault, so... Natsuki shakes her head, still looking down.
No! I don't even care that much. I'm just... having a really bad day today.
Natsuki sobs again. I didn't mean to take it out on you. What is going on with all these girls?
I really didn't mean to.
It's...
fine. Is there anything you want to talk about? Atsuki shakes her head. Just every day is so hard. Do you need a hug? I heard hugs are great. I love hugs. I just want to come to the club and... Atsuki falls silent again. I can't press her, so I can only do what I know how to. Listen? Alright. Well, I'll help clean this up. And I'll move the rest of your manga for you. I pick up volume 2 of Parfait Girls. We'll set this one aside. This will help you cheer up a bit, right? We can get started on it once I'm done here. My main character is so sweet! Natsuki looks up with her glossy eyes. Yo, I would fall for main characters so fast if I was Natsuki, to be honest. Her lips quiver. Her lip quivers. You're really nice to me. Well, no, why wouldn't I be? That sounds really strange coming from Natsuki. I didn't expect it at all. Well, I'm just treating you like a friend, you know? Natsuki lowers her head and stifles another sob. I'm not sure what happened to her today, but being nice is the least I could do. The next couple minutes are silent between us as I begin gathering the scattered books. I make sure to slip them into the box in their correct order. After a little bit, Natsuki starts helping. It isn't long before we're done, and I hoist the box onto the shelf where Natsuki wanted to put it. Then I get on the stool and I'm not that tall either. I quickly finish moving the rest of her books from the top shelf. All right, that should do it. I hop off the stool. Natsuki averts her gaze. Thanks. No worries. It's nothing. Natsuki is holding the volume I set aside in her hands. All right, I'm ready. Good. Even if you weren't, I'd make you anyway. You're taking responsibility for what you said. The thing about cheering me up. If you insist... We sit in the same spot as last time and I open the second volume. Natsuki's mood quickly improves, laughing and pointing things out to me. She's surprisingly sharp, making note of a lot of subtle, repeated jokes and background elements. In the end, I'm pretty impressed by how everything ties together in this manga. I guess Natsuki has good taste after all. After some time, Monika gets our attention as usual, and it's time to share poems again. Guess I'll be holding on to this for now. Yep! Even you sound more enthusiastic. I need a burp! Even you sound more enthusiastic this time. Well, I'm starting to get into it, you know? It's been a long time since I actually held a manga book and read it. I just, like, read manga on my phone. Told you! It's not the same feeling. Yeah. I return to my seat and slip the book into my bag. Alright, Natsuki. Of course, you're my first contender. Natsuki reads my poem. She keeps glancing at me and then back at the poem. By now, she must have read it more than once. Is it that bad? No, it's not. It's good. It's really good, okay? Yeah. It did it, guys. There, I said it. Ugh. This wasn't supposed to happen at all. Why can't you just be bad at this? My poems are supposed to impress you, not the other way around. You're trying to impress me? Obviously! You think I'd let you enjoy Yuri's writing more than mine? Give me a break. Well, in that case, what's the problem with me trying to impress you? Oh my god. I would die for this main character. I'll tell you, you... Natsuki's face freezes like she just realized something. You're trying to impress me? Of course! You're me! You're literally me! I'm impressing myself. Natsuki vigorously scans her eyes over my poem one more time. Then the poem slips out of her hands and flutters to the floor. Hey, pick up my poem! That's my hard work! I have to use the bathroom! Red-faced Natsuki quickly walks out of the room. Hey, Michiko! Did you do something to Natsuki? No. I just saw her rush out like that. You didn't do anything terrible, did you? No! She just read my poem, whatever the poem said. I just told her that... Oh, wait. My voice gets caught in my throat. There's no way I could tell Monika that I'm trying to impress Natsuki. Monika sees the poem lying on the floor and swiftly picks it up. She reads through it, her smile not fading from her face. I see. You wrote this for Natsuki, didn't you?
Stop! You're embarrassing me!
I mean... Not really. In fact, didn't she like your poem a lot the other day too? Let's not bring that up. I'm surprised you know her taste so well already. Are you sure you're not cheating me? Cheating? Cheating? Cheating on what? Cheating how? Cheating? What do you mean by that? Never mind, I'm just kidding. What do you mean? Who am I cheating on? Or who? How? What? I am a single guy in this game and I can fall in love with whoever I want. I didn't understand Monica's joke at all. Anyway, how do you think Natsuki feels about you? Oh, you don't need to answer that. It was just something for you to think about. Hey! Natsuki comes up and snatches the poem out of Monica's hands. Neither of us had noticed her re-enter the classroom. Did you read this, Monica? Of course, I liked it. Ugh! You should really stop reading things that aren't for you, you know? You have a bad habit of doing that. Huh? But Michiko wrote this poem, and we're supposed to share with everyone, right? Ugh. Natsuki freezes. She apparently forgot that my poem is technically for everyone to read. She thought I was writing to her heart. Okay, well, I think Michiko's done sharing this poem with everyone. I only shared it with you. It's not like anyone would want to read this anyway. In fact, I'm just going to hold on to this. If you insist. What? Huh? What, Monica? Why are you looking at me like that? Like what? Ugh! Never mind. Natsuki, I'll give you the poem, but it's still not very fair to Sayori. She hasn't gotten to read it yet. So what? Well, I guess Michiko is right, Natsuki. It's not fair if you don't let everyone finish reading it. Fine. Natsuki returns my poem. It's not like she's going to like it, though. Anyway, read my poem now. Thank you. And no, I won't let you keep it. This is my only copy. But you wanted to keep mine? I'll be your beach? Okay. Your mind is so full of troubles and fears that diminish your wonder over the years. But today I have a special place, a beach for us to go. A shore reaching beyond your sight, a sea that sparkles with brilliant light. The walls in your mind will melt away before the sunny glow. I'll be the beach that washes your worries away. I'll be the beach that you daydream about each day. I'll be the beach that makes your heart leap in a way that you thought had left you long ago. Let's bury your heavy thoughts in a pile of sand, bathe in sunbeams and hold my hand. Wash your insecurities in the salty sea and let me see you shine. Let's leave your memories in a footprint trail, set you free in my windy sail. And remember the reasons you're wonderful when you press your lips to mine. I'll be the beach that washes your worries away. I'll be the beach that you daydream about each day. I'll be the beach that makes your heart leap in a way that you thought had left you long. I don't know why that line keeps tripping me up. But if you let me by your side, your own beach, your own escape, you'll learn to love yourself again. That was sweet. Yeah, I felt like I kept writing about negative things, so I wanted to write something with a nice message for once. It is. It's kind of like sad as well, though, because, like, you're basically asking if they want to stay and if they want to accept you as their, like, safe haven. Besides, the beach is awesome. Too bad I can't swim, Natsuki. Kind of hard to write anything negative about the beach. What do you mean? You could write so many negative things about the beach. About, like, the people that die that can't swim, aka me, the people that drown, you know? There's negative things about the beach. Being attacked. So you decided to write about the beach first, and then came up with the message later? Yeah, well, it's only because of what happened yesterday. I mean, after Yuri and I realized we kind of wrote about the same thing. She wanted to pick a topic and have us both write about it or whatever. Ugh, you can really see her doing that too. Making us write about a simple topic, then trying to impress me by coming up with something all fancy. Well, it's not like I care. I just did it anyway. I mean, I guess mine ended up being kind of metaphorical too, but there's nothing wrong with doing that once in a while. At the very least, it was a good practice. Okay. Sayori! It's nice, I guess. Come on, I can already tell you don't like it. Well, you don't need to worry about what I think. After all, you wrote this for someone else, didn't you? Don't come at me like that. Don't come at me like that. Probably Natsuki. I didn't write this for anyone specifically. Lies, I did. Maybe. That's not really what I meant, though. But it's okay. You're making new friends, just like I was hoping. That makes me really happy. And you were happy too, right? In this club? Well, of course I am. Good. That's all that matters to me. Thank you, Michiko. Sayori, is there something wrong? Huh? No, nothing. I'm just a little tired today. Alright, just tell me if you need anything. I will. Don't worry about me, okay? You can go play with everyone else now. If you insist. Yay! I'm gonna go home a little bit early today. Sayori? Tell Monika I wasn't feeling well, okay? I'll see you tomorrow! Before I can say anything else, Sayori cheerfully walks out of the classroom, humming to herself. You didn't even share me your poem! What? This isn't good. Are you gonna share your poem today, Yuri? Yuri doesn't look too enthusiastic about spending time with me. I guess if she changes her mind, she'll come to me. But I should leave her be for now, alright. Well, I'm gonna end the episode off after Monika's. We're losing all these girls. The girls are all just dropping away from me. Hi, Michiko. Have you thought about what you want to submit to perform at the festival? Well, being in this club is one thing, but performing in front of a bunch of people, I'll have to give it some more thought. Okay, no pressure. But whatever you do, I'm sure it'll turn out great. It would also make me happy to see. Okay. Anyway, I already read your poem, but you can go ahead and read mine now. Alright. The lady who knows everything. An old tale tells of a lady who wanders Earth. The lady who knows everything. A beautiful lady who has found every answer. All meaning, all purpose, and all that was ever sought. And here I am, a feather. Lost adrift the sky, victim of the currents of the wind. Day after day I search. I search with little hope, knowing legends don't exist. But when all else has failed me, when all others have turned away, the legend is all that remains. The last dim star glimmering in the twilight sky. Until one day the wind ceases to blow, I fall, and I fall and fall and fall even more. Gentle as a feather, a dry quill, expressionless. But a hand catches me between the thumb and forefinger. The hand of a beautiful lady. I look at her eyes and find no end to her gaze. The lady who knows everything knows what I am thinking. Before I can speak, she responds in a hollow voice. I have found every answer, all of which amount to nothing. There is no meaning, there is no purpose, and we seek only the impossible. Wow. And I am not your legend. Your legend does not exist. Wow. And with a breath, she blows me back afloat, and I pick up a gust of wind. Wow. You know, I feel like learning and looking for answers are the sort of things that give life meaning. Not to get too philosophical. Philosophical? I feel like I'm saying that wrong. Or anything. But it was kind of on my mind, so that's what I wrote about. I see. I never really put much thought into it. In a way, it's almost paradoxical. Because if we had all the answers, wouldn't the world start to lose its meaning? You know, there's one thing I noticed. It seems like everyone in the club prefers writing about things that are more sad than happy. Are you surprised? I mean, if everything was okay, we wouldn't really have anything to write about, would we? Humans aren't two-dimensional creatures. I think you'd know that better than anyone. You mean one-dimensional? Yeah, that. Anyway, here's Monika's writing tip of the day. Are you ever too shy to share your writing because you're afraid it's not that good? It can be really disheartening to get a lukewarm response to something you put so much into. But if you find other people who enjoy writing, then sharing becomes a lot easier. Because instead of just telling you that your writing is good or okay or bad, they want to focus more on everything that went into it and the things you can work on. It's much more encouraging that way, and it will make you want to continue improving. It's almost like having your own literature club, don't you think? That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening. Whatever that meant. Okay, you three. I will see you in the next episode, because that's where we're going to end for today's episode. Because Sayori left early. Does that mean we're going to be able to walk Natsuki home? I really pray to God Sayori is not going to die while I'm trying to go for Natsuki's route. Because that's not right. I just hope she's just going to be a little sad. And then she's going to finally come out to me and be like, hey, this is why I've been feeling this way. Please. Please. Please, Sayori, please. My heart is not ready for anything. But anyway, thank you guys for watching today's episode. Stay beautiful, and I'll see you guys in the next one. I'm 느낌 없었는데 매일 지겹대면서 울